Formula One returns to Interlagos once again, with the stage set for what promises to be another classic Sao Paulo Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel famously clinched his third championship here in 2012, and just 4 years later, Max Verstappen treated us to one of the finest wet weather drives of all time. Interlagos, always a very special race here in Brazil. It's a 2.7-mile circuit with 9 lefts and 6 rights, for a total of 15 corners. The fastest lap today should have an average speed of around 135 miles per hour, if, of course, the weather stays dry until the end of the Grand Prix. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Lightning lines up on pole position, and Oscar Piastri completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Albon, Doohan, Helger, Drugovic, Norris, Vesti, Russell, Leclerc, Liam Lawson, Gasly, Hakkinen, Ocon, Deruvola, Stroll, Tsunoda, Joe, Magnussen, De Vries, Teo Pourchaire, and Logan Sargeant. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. It's just about time to go down to the track for the beginning of the race, but before we do, Anthony Davidson, what types of strategy do you think we can expect for today's event?
Well, there's a lot that both the driver and the team have to keep in mind when going into a race. The tyres, fuel, energy recovery systems, the list goes on and on. But I think the key to today's victory will come down to the pit stop strategy. Come in too soon and you might find yourself needing more than one stop. Too late and you're putting yourself at a disadvantage by spending longer on worn tyres.
Seeing any technical issues coming off the practice start. Watch the RPM on the full start. We don't want you to bog down. No threat of rain for the time being, conditions look good. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get a good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. We'll be right back. DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. So we're leading our teammate by 19.0 seconds. Information on Lawson. Right, they've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. We're approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. We'll be right back. Caution, caution. Okay, clear. Okay, we want you to pit this lap, so push now, push. Look after these tyres now, you want to finish the race on this compound. We'll be right back. Mika's in the pits. Mika is in the pits. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Gap to your teammate behind is 32.7 seconds. Fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done. Turbocharger's on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. That's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, we're looking at some gearbox wear, so try to keep the number of shifts to a minimum, please. Final lap. Enjoy this one, my friend. Enjoy it.
And with that, another year of Formula One draws to a close and a new World Drivers' Champion is declared. Another entry added to that prestigious list of the sport's most incredible drivers. Not just victory today then, but the championship as well. What a spectacular season they've had. Congratulations to the whole team. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
This also means there's no catching our leader anymore, and we crown a new World Drivers' Champion. So let's review.
Our income's solid at the moment. We should start considering where we can look to invest the profits we're making back into the team.